brother, brother, there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today.
When we began to talk about what we would do when we go to public housing, we saw it as an issue of recovery and not an issue of going to run people out of public housing, but to take control through recovery. That's why we said it's recovery time. It's recovery time. So our thrust has been to pursue and engage in recovery. The pusher needs recovery. The user needs recovery. The residents who live in public housing need recovery. In fact, the whole housing project needs recovery.
Taking control does not mean that we're going to run folks out. We're there to embrace people. We're there to enhance our relationship with our brothers and sisters.
It's very important to have a tenants association, to have people on the inside who are there as residents, who are sick and tired of destructive forces that come into play in their lives every day. Colleen Williams was critical for us coming together.
It took a lot of going to meetings. It took a lot of getting involved with a lot of different organizations, and I just felt that being a resident there, that it could be made to be a better place, and it could be made a safe place.
We have an obligation to worry more about the larger quality of life issues than simply those which are our main mandate, and that is to provide good, safe, decent, and clean housing. So we're particularly pleased to be able to have joined with GLIDE, with Reverend Williams, with the tenants at Valencia Gardens, with the community agencies around this terrific city. We understand the role that we must play in all of that, and we're certainly ready and able to do so.
And because of the magnitude of 700 or 800 people together, what we would do is create a human force which would in effect affect the people there, and that's exactly what happened.
We at least have 15 programs that we're going to bring into the Valencia Gardens starting today.
We exposed a number of people there who had been beaten and brutalized and misused, senior citizens and other folks. We got people who had from smoke houses or crack houses right in the public housing project, brought them up on stage. They talked. But what we came up on, which shocked us and surprised us, was the fact that we met a young man called Alex, and that's all I knew him by that day.
It was like I heard Cecil talk, and I wasn't so much worried about myself. I was just worried about what he can do for the people. You know, what are you willing to do for them? Because I was going to get mine anyways. And once he got to tell him, it was like, yeah, this is it, man. This is what I want to be a part of. This is what I'm about. I guess this is what I've been looking for a while. But more or less, I've also been kind of looking for a way out, whether it was illegally or legally. But I was always taught from my father, no matter what you do, be your best at what you're at. You know what I'm saying? So I took the bad road, you know, was being crooked, being a, you know what I'm saying, a hood, you know, a criminal, or whatever you want to call it, whatever people call it. And I just was good at what I was at. And I figured, well, I'm getting tired of it. I did a little time. Now I have a son. I have a family. You know, I can get a job. And after all, if things don't work, I can always turn back to what I was doing before. Then, you know, I have someone who's there by my side, which is my baby's mother. Been together 5 years, and she told me, why even turn back? She said, you can make an honest living, you know. So I was like, start thinking about it, and then just that Saturday came, and here Cecil came with his, the rest of his staff, man.
And as we talked, Alex said to me something like, and some of the others said to me, you know, you're making a circus out of coming out of all of this, out of all of us. It's just a circus. And I said, I disagree with you. It's not a circus. I planned this along with literally hundreds of people, and we're here to try to help people make decisions about their recovery.
Alex was kind of a leader when he was on the opposite side of the fence. And I'm hoping that he will be as good a leader on this side as he was on the outside. A lot of the young adults and the children and the teenagers, they look up to Alex. So hopefully he will be a role model for them. I'm enjoying working with him, and it's making me feel good to know that there's at least one that has changed and has turned around. And I feel that if you can save one, eventually you will save a whole group, because they will begin to follow.
I was a part of it. I was the one that got people to paint. You know, it was a good feeling. It got to where after the walls were painted, it wasn't about the walls anymore if they got painted over. It was about the people. It was a totally different change in the people. People were lined up. People that don't even speak to each other were talking to each other, you know, smiling, having a good time, just kicking away, you know what I'm saying? They were lined up, getting a little something to eat, and it was just great. You know, I didn't even want to pay the people for a little while, because I just wanted them to stay there together for a while, just to be able to just get to know each other. It was a good feeling. It was like, damn, I did this. You know what I'm saying? And it was just, people were just willing to get out there and help, you know, help make some good. That's all. They just wanted to help make some good, man. I mean, you got all this bad stuff out there, you know, where's the good, you know? And once they seen it, they just wanted to be a part of it.
The heavy emphasis is on the criminal justice system, on sending people to prison and to jail and incarcerating people and putting people out of, taking people out of the community. I want to keep people in the community. We hope to come up with models that are emerging in America that will speak to recovery and treatment and intervention.
Glory, come on, stand and sing.
It's recovery time. So don't run. Don't try to escape. Our sons and daughters need to come home. And we're coming home to our sons and daughters. Wherever you are, we're coming to you. Because we're coming ultimately and finally with unconditional love. Oh, my family.